हेलो नमस्ते एवरीवन, आई एम देवेश पुरोहित एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर मोनोलॉग आई वुड लाइक टू स्पीक अबाउट सर्कल ऑफ लेगेसी बिल्डिंग थियोरी विच आई हैव कैप्चर्ड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर बुक थियोरी ऑफ रेफरेंस बिल्डिंग लेगेसी मैट्रिक्स एंड इट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थियोरी फॉर लेगेसी मैट्रिक्स एंड लेगेसी बिल्डिंग. सो आई हैव लेड द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ फेम, स्टारडम एंड लेगेसी एंड आई हैव डिस्टिंग्विश्ड बिटवीन दैम. सो इमेजिन अ सर्कल एंड डिवाइड दैट इंटू थ्री पार्ट्स. वन इज फॉर फेम, वन इज फॉर स्टारडम एंड वन इज फॉर लेगेसी. ओके, सो फेम इज बेसिकली ऑल अबाउट रिकग्निशन एंड पॉपुलैरिटी. इट कैन बी फॉर अ पर्सन और अ प्रोडक्ट, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, एनी ब्रांड. इट एंड वेन वी से स्टारडम, इट मीन्स एक्सेप्टेंस, लाइकेबिलिटी, इन्फ्लुएंस, राइट? एंड ऑफकोर्स फेम इज अ पार्ट ऑफ स्टारडम. एंड वेन वी स्पीक ऑफ लेगेसी, इट इज अबाउट रिस्पेक्ट, क्रेडिबिलिटी and influence and acceptance. Okay, so that is what I would in a brief distinguish and highlight on this. And as my theory says that fame is B2C in nature, stardom is D2C in nature, and legacy is B2B in nature. If I elaborate this briefly, suppose a person is famous or a product is famous or as something is ongoing, so that is used as a vehicle, as a catalyst to promote a message of the organization, brand, whatever. Okay, suppose let's say cricket is in talks due to World Cup or IPL. So this brand wagon effect and moment marketing and all is used to convey a message using these analogies or backgrounds. Okay, or it can be, let's say a XYZ person is famous. And so that person is used to endorse a particular product, event, brand, whatever. Okay, influencer marketing also is running on this particular concept now. So that's the thing. And stardom is D2C in nature. When I say D2C, it's direct to consumer, but here slightly the definitions would vary. It's not hardcore consumer, but yeah, the followers, the admirers. Okay, mostly stardom is human centric. If you love Shah Rukh Khan or Virat Kohli, Taylor Swift, anybody you love, it is all between you and that personality. At times stardom can be product or brand centric as well. Just for example, when iPhones are launched across the world, like people actually stand in a queue to buy the updated versions and all. So yes, iPhones have seen stardom. To a certain extent, I would say even Ferrari has seen stardom. And when we say when Jio was introduced in India, it actually saw stardom. Like people were literally standing in queues just to get a SIM card. So at times, yeah, this can be product or brand specific, and even certain sports teams, maybe of football, maybe of cricket, they also see stardom as it is not only specific to a particular player or sports personality or influencer. It can be for a team as well. Let's say Royal Challengers Bangalore. Of course, it has a huge fan following because of Virat Kohli, but even if Virat Kohli might be out of the equation, it would have still have had some fan base. Okay, so that is about. And let's say even in the case of Kolkata Knight Riders, some personalities kept on changing, but it still had that fan following. And when I say personalities, I don't mean Shah Rukh Khan, I mean the other cricket players. So only in those contexts I'm talking about. And when I say legacy, it is B2B in nature. Okay, so whenever we give examples of legends or legacies, we want to persuade the people, we want to convince something with axioms and all. Okay, let's say William Shakespeare is not even alive. He obviously doesn't know me, he has not paid me a single penny. I am using his example to convince you, to convey a message to you about circle of legacy building. Or let's say Amitabh Bachchan doesn't know me, he has not paid me a single penny, but yeah, I can tell you that he is a legend. His life journey shows how circle of legacy building fits very well on him. So yeah, that is now a part of B2B interaction that I'm having with you. Or even other organizations, they, whenever there are pitch meetings, business meetings, anything, they use legacies or legendary examples to convey a message or to persuade the desired target audience and all. So that's why legacy is B2B in nature and it's a circle. So when you have legacy, then obviously you have fame, you have stardom as well, you have the influence, the recognition, credibility and everything. And if you have legacy, then it comes to fame again. Let's say hypothetically I'm now taking Albert Einstein in this conversation, okay, because he's a legend, I'm talking about him and is organically getting the fame. So that's why it is a circular nature. So yeah, that's why I've mentioned this as a circle of legacy building. Okay, so